Now from Chase Field in the capital city of Phoenix, Arizona, MLB Network is on the air. Today we've got a good matchup ahead between the New York Mets and the Arizona Diamondbacks. Live baseball here on MLB Network, and it comes your way next. Patrick Corbin out of the 49th state of Alaska is on the mound. Harold, what do you got?
As you look at certain pitchers, you look at their numbers, you say, wow, he must really enjoy pitching at home, because you look at his road numbers, he's really struggled. This is the case with him. He loves pitching at home. I think he grabs an energy from the home crowd and is able to really have a good performance.
Off with a map.
Set to go now as Curtis Granderson is into the box to get this one underway. And underway from the desert as the first pitch of the afternoon is taken here for ball one. Well, Harold Reynolds, these Diamondbacks, as they begin play, they'll look to make it three straight here as they come in on the heels of two straight wins.
Well, Matt, I really like their pitching staff, but I think the key to this game is clearly falls on their shoulders. They throw off-speed pitches for strikes, and they mix the pitch as well. I think if they do that, they got a chance to win.
Shorts and T-shirts, the order of the afternoon, 92 degrees here at first pitch. Now he gets on top of one here and chops it foul right at home plate. Granderson waits on the 1-2, and a slider's in the dirt as he lays off it for a ball. Into the windup, here comes the 2-2 pitch. And a good pitch there as this is swung on and missed for the first out of the ball game. And now a chance to meet the Mets. How do they get back into the win column here, Harold?
Everybody knows this is a hitter's ballpark. You hit a ball in the air, it's going to carry. You hit a ball on the ground, it's going to get through. But the key to hitter's ballpark is don't try to do too much. You know the pitcher's going to nibble, and you don't have to touch it. Just reach out and put it in play, and the ball can carry. So contact is the key to hitting in a hitter's ballpark.
First pitch of the at-bat. As Drubel Cabrera comes on with one gone here as he looks at a called strike one. And there are our umpires for this one. Working the plate is Dave Lawrence.
Now, Matt, Dave Lawrence is going to remind you a lot of James Kingsley. He comes from that old school of you hit your spots, he's going to call it. He has a tendency to call one side of the plate a little bit more than the other.
Swing and he pops him up over toward foul territory. And no one will get this one. Into the windup, here comes the 0-2 pitch. And he'll try to get him to chase the fastball there, but he lays off 1-2. Bases are empty, one man out. Little chopper back to the mound. Throw in time at first for out number two.
Got his third. Center fielder number 12.
Juan Ligares. First chance for him here in the top of the first with nobody on. First delivery to him on the way. Swing and a miss out in front of a changeup. And a neck high fastball that time. Just settling in here in Phoenix for this one. Out in front of a fastball as this is ripped down the left field line. That's going to be a fair ball. Throw into second. Not in time, and he's in there with a double.
As we look again at that double here, you can see that he was thinking too right out of the box. Smashed it down the line, and that was some great hustle to beat the throw to second to earn himself a double.
Here's Jay Bruce now as he takes a fastball off the plate for a ball 1-0. Great chance to drive in a run here in the early going. decent lead at second. Here's the pitch. Oh, much too tardy on the fastball. 1-1.
This could be an interesting night for him. He gives up the extra base hit, and then he makes a location pitch that he needs to make. If he does that consistently, he'll have a good night.
He's set. Here comes the 1-1. In the dirt here. Runner holds as the count moves to 2-1. Set and the 2-1 pitch. Line drive to left. That's in there. Base hit. Lagares rounds third and is digging for the plate. And he will beat the tag. Safe at the plate.
Well, Matt, as you know, they haven't been scoring many runs lately. Maybe this is the catalyst to get things going for them and pull them out of this losing streak. That's a big RBI single for them early in the game.
Here's Neil Walker. He's been one of their big run producers this year, currently third on the team in RBIs. Inside with the fastball, it's 1-0. Two out with the man at first. And he won't bite at that one either. It's 2-0.
On 2-0, you can bet he's looking for a fastball that he can turn on and drive. Might be thinking about picking on that big hole between first and second.
Ready with the 2-0. Swinging a soft liner in there, a base hit. And that runner will go no further than second as there are two aboard now.
Well, he got jammed on that one right there, and he's strong enough to muscle it into right field for the base hit. It's going to be a line drive tomorrow in the paper.
Now batting, Michael Conforto. He comes in currently second on the team in home runs. Ready to deliver. Here's the first pitch. Sends that one out of play for strike one.
Come on, D-back. Go.
0-1 count and the pitch. A fastball that just misses inside.
What good inside fastball right there. Trying to tie the hitter up, trying to keep him from getting those arms extended. A pitcher's pitch.
A 1-1 count. Here's the pitch. And a fastball not close. It's 2-1 now.
A lot of times you see guys get too aggressive and try to do too much at the plate with guys on. But right here, he's doing a great job of waiting on the right pitch. Got himself ahead in the count now.
Get out of here, Matt.
Ready to deal. Here's the 2-1. And he swings on top of one here and chops it foul right at home plate. He's set. Here's the 2-2. And the changeup just missed the inside corner.
Well, we got a big pitch coming up now. That's ball three right there. And look at with this situation with two guys already on, you don't want to load the bases. You got to come after them, make them swing the bat.
He's ready. Now the payoff pitch. Good swing on a tough pitch, and he'll stick around to see another one. Two down, runners at first and second. And we'll see another pitch here as this ball's chopped foul at home plate. Another one sent foul. Another payoff pitch. And look out. That's in very tight, and it's ball four.
Wow, he's looking awfully shaky to start this game, guys. That's three hits and a walk. And there's no doubt that he's fighting himself right now. See if he can get this train back on the rails here.
Digging in the switch hitter, Jose Reyes. And a quick glance at the numbers will tell you it's been a huge struggle for him at the plate this year. A fastball here as he'll take a look at ball one, 1-0.
Well, Matt, I'm looking at his high pitch count here in the first inning. They've done a great job of being patient and making him work. The key here, keep that pitch count up and maybe you'll get in that bullpen.
Ready with the 1-0 pitch. Chopped weakly to the left. Fielded cleanly. Throw on to second for the force, and the side is retired. So one run on three hits, no errors, and they leave the bases loaded. On now to the bottom of inning number one. It's the Mets one, and the Diamondbacks nothing. Matt Harvey gets the starting nod for the Mets. Harold, any thoughts?
The way I see him, Matt, he's really struggled because he allows a lot of base runners, whether it's by the walk or by the hit. And when you have that much traffic on the base paths, you're going to eventually give up runs. So he's got to eliminate that and give his team and himself a chance to win this game.
At the plate, A.J. Pollock. And as you take a look at the splits here, he's actually better against right-handed pitching this season. Just off the outside, and it's 1-0. These Mets herald as they take the field here today. They are in the midst of a pretty bad stretch as they've dropped six straight coming in.
Well, Matt, every team's going to go through a losing streak, but you got to try to do something that's going to pull you out of it. One game at a time is really what you got to think about, because if you don't, before you know it, five games leads to 10, and 10 games leads to 15. And before you know it, you're out of it. You lost a ton of games in a row.
In now, David Peralta, and he really thrives in the batter's box here at home. Something to keep an eye on in this one. He comes set. Here's the nothing and nothing pitch. And there's one well above the zone for a ball. Here comes the 1-0. And there's a pitch that just misses the inside corner.
Well, I'll tell you, he doesn't look very comfortable on this mound right now. This mound isn't the same one that he pitches at home. I know they all look the same, but they're not all the same.
Harvey now on 2-0. Down low, and the plot thickens here. 3-0.
Good check swing on that off-speed pitch. Clearly he's sitting fastball ready to let it fly. He recognized it was an off-speed pitch and was able to hold up.
Here it comes on 3-0. Hit high but foul as that'll get in amongst the fans.
Ooh, that was a good pitch to hit. He wants that one back. He was just a little bit late on it.
3-1. Here it is. That misses. So a single and a walk, and it's first and second with nobody out.
Looked like he might have gotten squeezed a little bit right there, and you know he's talking to himself in his head about it. That kind of stuff goes both ways, though. Hitters get their fair share of crummy calls going against them, too.
Here's Paul Goldschmidt now, as he'll take strike one on the inside corner. He'll enter play at 313, 9 homers and 31 RBIs. Nothing in one count. Here it comes. A swing and a miss just out in front of that fastball. First and second here with nobody out. Fouled off into the seats behind first.
That's probably not what he wants to do with two strikes right there with the fastball. He is fortunate he just fouled it off.
Now the 0-2 pitch. Now a little pop up off toward the first base side. And this is going to get down. It's a foul ball.
That's a nice job of staying alive. A two strike breaking ball just out of the zone. He was able to put enough on it to get another pitch.
Now a ball lifted high in the air towards shallow right center field. Granderson has the best view of this one, so he'll take it for the first down. And now here's a look at the Diamondbacks starting lineup. HR, how do they send their fan base home happy here today?
Well, Matt, they find themselves already down one. The big thing here, realize you got a lot of game left. Just score one run. Try to get right back in the game, even it up, and play the whole nine innings. You can't just play part of the game, play the whole game.
Standing in, Jake Lamb. And there's a look at his home and road splits so far this year. He's set. Here it comes. There's a changeup over the outside corner.
Hey, when one of your better pitches is the straight changeup, you can't be afraid to throw it at any count and at any time. And hey, first pitch, if they're going to take it for strike one, they're going to give it to you. Go ahead and throw it.
Lifted the other way out to left center. Conforto will range to his left as he tracks this one down in left center for the second out of the inning. Here's Yasmani Tomas. The average for him entering play sits down in the 250s. Harvey pauses. First pitch on its way. Swings through the slider there. Two men are on with two men out. And that misses, one and one.
I like that they went away with that pitch right there. They really tried to tie him up on that previous pitch, so he was probably what we call inside conscious. He didn't get a strike there, but I'm guessing he was looking for another ball in.
He's set. Here comes the 1-1. Now a ball swung on and heading for the stands in right, and that'll move the count to 1-2 now.
He appears to be having some issues with pitch command to start the game. He's dealing with two guys on, and that last pitch looked like a big mistake in that location, right down the middle, but he got away with it.
From the belt, the pitch. Swing and a miss, and that ends the inning. Few of these folks need to get out of the sun. More baseball on MLB Network right after this. Ready now, Rene Rivera. He's hitting just above the batter 300 mark on the season coming into this one. Into the windup and the pitch. Trying to work that slider to the outer half, but it misses 1-0.
Backdoor breaking ball just missed right there. It's such an effective pitch if you can hit the corner with it, but no dice this time.
Into his windup, here comes the 1-0. And that one stayed too low, apparently. takes a fastball on the inside corner. Gets the sign. Here comes the 2-1. Sent on the ground out to second. Rury has it. Throw to first will be in time, and there's one gone here to start the second.
All right, time for the majestic defensive alignment for the D-backs. And I'm looking at third baseman Jake Lamb. Now, they put him in the outfield every now and then, but he's primarily a third baseman. I think he surprised a lot of people coming out of the University of Washington. They didn't think he was going to have this kind of power. He's not only got power, he's got good range defensively as well.
Striding into the box, Matt Harvey. He'll get to take his first cuts here. He's ready. Here's the first offering. A high fastball is in there. We're in the second. 1-0 Mets early on. Swing and a miss. It's 0-2.
Well, that's two impressive fastballs. Two mid-90s fastballs just reaching back saying, I dare you to hit it. Finds himself in a nice 0-2 count now.
0-2. Here it comes. Now a swing and a miss. He struck him out. And it's two up, two down to start the second.
Nice two-seam fastball there. You don't usually see a lot of swings and misses with that pitch unless it's really moving. So that one must have had some real good late life.
In is Curtis Granderson.
Yes, he'll take a look at ball one. He was a strikeout victim to open up the ball game. The 1-0 home now to Granderson. And the slider stayed low apparently for a ball.
Well, not a great spot to be in right now. 2-0 to a great hitter like this. This is when you really have to pay attention as a pitcher. And if you have good off-speed stuff, this might be the time to start mixing in your off-speed stuff.
Right on the corner, a fastball that he takes for a strike. And a fastball in the dirt that's taken for a ball. Into his motion, here comes the 3-1. Takes a high fastball for a strike. And now a pitch on the way. Neither guy willing to give in, and the at-bat will continue. Looking to punch him out again, the pitch. And he misses here for ball four. Already two walks surrendered in his first couple of innings of work.
Well, this guy's been prone to giving up walks and bunches, and that's already two walks here in the early going. We'll see if this continues to be an issue for him as this start continues.
Stepping in and ready for another shot as Drubel Cabrera, 0-for-1 here in the early going. He's ready. Here's the first offering. A slider that just grabs the outside corner. A runner on first with two away. And this misses the outside corner, so it's knotted up at 1-1. Now a snap move over to first. Runner back safely. He's set. Here comes the 1-1. Chop foul over towards the dugout. Set to deal on a ball and two strikes. And this one gets away. And he'll make it into scoring position here with two away, as that'll be scored a wild pitch.
Well, the intent there with that two-strike pitch was obviously to get him to fish for something he couldn't do a whole lot with, but there's the risk that comes with that as well. If you don't execute or your catcher can't handle it very well, you give up free bases.
2-2 count. Here it comes. Hit well on the ground to first. Goldschmidt will take this to the bag himself, and with that, the inning comes to a close. Mets leave one, and after an inning and a half, it's 1-0. Brandon Drury will bat next. He'll begin things here against Matt Harvey.
Second baseman, Brandon Drury.
Into the windup and the pitch. Good swing. Just got to try and straighten that one out.
Oh, he's going to want that pitch again. That ball's right down the middle in his wheelhouse. His eyes lit up. He just didn't let it travel deep enough where he could square it and keep it fair.
Off the plate, one ball, one strike. From the windup, the 1-1 pitch. Now a swing and a ball popped high in the air over toward foul ground. And this is taken in out there by Bruce for the first out.
Well, let's take a look at the Mets defense brought to you by Majestic. And in the outfield, Michael Conforto. He's had to learn how to play on the corners. He was a center fielder in college, but now playing on the corners, he's had to learn all the angles. But it looked like he caught on quick.
Here's Chris Owings now. He enters play in this one with his batting average up over the 320 mark. First pitch coming. Here it is. This ball's hit in the air down the right side and out of play. 0-1. Into the windup. Here comes the 0-1. Another one fouled off, and he's quickly behind 0-2. Two strikes now from Harvey. Popped into the air, back behind second. And that's in there. Base hit. He'll get it into second, but he'll be in there with a double.
Batting eighth, catcher Patrick Corbin.
Stepping in now, Patrick Corbin, as he will look at a first pitch fastball for ball one. Well, we'll give you a look there at the graphic. The double is his eighth of the season so far. One out and a runner on second base. Now a pickoff play at second, and he's back easily. And the fastball is off his glove, and it gets away. And he'll make it to third here on what will likely be ruled a passed ball.
Looked like a four-seamer that just kept rising on him, and he couldn't get the mitt up in time to catch it. Really no excuse for that. That'll go as a passed ball, and deservedly so.
Here comes the 2-0 pitch. Got himself a 2-0 fastball there, but he couldn't connect. 2-1. He's set, and the 2-1 pitch. Slice down the left side, but foul. Working for the punch out and the offering. He got him, and it'll probably take a base hit now to get that runner across from third.
That strikeout changes the whole complexion of the inning. He was definitely pitching for it with a runner on third and one out, and he got it. Now it's going to take a hit or something like a wild pitch to get that guy home.
Now at the plate, Jeff Mathis. And he is proving to be something of a non-threat with a bat in his hands this year. The average isn't pretty. First delivery to him on the way. Now a swing and a hard hit grounder. This is foul for the first strike.
Oh, he had him fooled there. No balls and two strikes.
What a good pitch. He went way out of the zone to try to swing and catch up to that slider. Now you got him thinking. It's 0-2. You can throw him anything you want.
On its way, the 0-2 pitch. And a fastball in the dirt, but it's blocked nicely as he keeps it in front of him. Men on third with two down. Pitch swung on and hit in the air. Granderson on the move. He's got it. A great running play, and that'll retire the side. One left for Arizona. They trail this one 1-0. Back now in the desert southwest, set for the top of the third from Chase Field in Phoenix. Here's Juan Lagares. He'll lead things off here in this one-run contest. 12,
Juan Lagares.
And this is fouled back and out of play. The windup and the 0-1. And there's one he'd like to have over again, missed high with the slider.
So that's two pitches in a row above the belt. As a hitter, that's what you're looking for, especially when it's a day game and the ball is carrying. That just wasn't a good enough pitch to hit.
Here's the 1-1 pitch. And a ball popped foul to the right side, out of play. And here's a ball hit in the air. Goldschmidt will pull this one in over near the first base dugout for out number one. So with one away, it's time to give you a good look at the standings out west in the National League as you see where the Diamondbacks sit entering play here today. So one away here with the bases empty, and stepping in the dangerous left-handed hitter Jay Bruce. Here comes the first pitch. Here's a two-seamer inside to start the at-bat. It's 1-0. The windup and the 1-0 pitch. Swing and a liner towards second. And he'll whip this one over to first, and he gets his man for the second out.
Up next for the Mets, second baseman, Neil Walker.
Ready for another chance? Neil Walker, a base hit in his first trip. Ready to deliver. Here's the first pitch. Fastball's too high here, 1-0. Walker waits on the 1-0. Takes this the other way to right. That's in another base hit. He's 2-for-2.
Well, that one right there, he let the ball travel. It got back in on him, but now it didn't beat him. He's strong enough to shoot it the other way. Michael stayed inside the ball for the base hit.
Into the box now, Michael Conforto, and he sends one deep down the right field line. And he will get there to make the running play, and that will end the inning. Mets strand one. They lead it 1-0. Digging in to try it again, A.J. Pollock. He'll get us going in the home half of inning number three.
A.J. Pollock.
Here's the first pitch to him. Lined but speared on a hop. And a flip to first from Cabrera in time for the first out.
The right
so one away in the
six.
Inning now. And before we get too much David further, Peralta. Let's take a look at where the Mets find themselves in the race for the National League East. Digging in for his second at bat, David Peralta. He drew a base on balls his first time up. And he takes a cold strike, 0-1. Into the windup, here comes the 0-1. dribbled to the right side. On to first, and very quickly, two are gone here in the home third.
The first baseman, number 44, Paul Goldschmidt.
Here's Paul Goldschmidt now. 0 for 1 for him here in this one. There's a fastball that just misses, ball one. Harvey's ready. Here's the 1-0. Now it's 2-0.
Hey, pitching isn't always about getting everyone out. Sometimes it's about being smart and knowing when to pick your battles. He's been really careful with this hitter so far, and rightfully so.
From the windup, the 2-0 pitch. 3-0 now.
Falling behind 3-0 to the wrong guy right here. You don't want to mess around with him. You know he's going to have the green light. If you throw one inside, he still might turn and burn.
3-0 pitch on its way. Takes a knee-high fastball. Into his motion. Here comes the 3-1. Grounded to short. Throw on to first. Gets him, and the side is retired. Diamondbacks down in order. It remains 1-0. Striding in once again, Jose Reyes comes into this at bat 0-for-1 in the ballgame. He's ready. Here's the first offering. On the ground to third. Lamb scoops it up. Throw to first in time. One gone here in the fourth.
Now batting. Catcher, Rene Rivera.
Stepping into the box, Rene Rivera. He's 0-for-1 thus far. Into the windup and the pitch. A fastball down near the shoe tops. Pitch on the way. Lays off again, and it's 2-0. Count and the pitch. Outside, 3-0 now.
Well, he knows it, but this is the kind of guy you just have to go right after. He's not the biggest threat with the bat, so it's time to challenge him right here.
One run, four hits, and no errors on the Mets line score so far. And that misses as well. Ball four, so it's a four-pitch walk here.
The pitcher, number 33, Matt Harvey.
Coming to the plate now, Matt Harvey. 0-for-1 for him here in this one. First pitch on its way. Now a bunt attempt here. Flip to the second baseman covering now for the out.
Here's one that you don't see too often, right? Safe at second base, but out at first. Great hustle there from the runner going into second. Really showed off his speed.
In is Curtis Granderson, as he'll try to hold back on the swing, but he went around for the first strike. 0-for-2 here to start the afternoon. Let's do it, guys. 0-1 count. Here's the pitch. Oh, and you talk about a pitcher getting the benefit of the doubt. That's low, but called a strike anyway. Nothing in two now. One run, four hits, and no errors on the Mets line score so far. And a wasted pitch there, 1-2.
Decided to go with a fastball there on 0-2, but what he's trying to do with that pitch is to expand the strike zone. Maybe you get a guy to offer at it, but at the very least, it helps set up your off-speed stuff.
ball and two strikes. Here it is. And he lays off a pitch outside as they draw even at 2-2.
Kind of pitching him backwards in this AB. Soft stuff early. Then those last two were fastballs trying to get it right by him.
Trying to send him packing for the second time. Waved at and missed for the third out. Not much of a chance at hitting that one, and the inning is over. Mets leave one, but they're up 1-0. Settling in now, Jake Lamb. He's set to lead us off in the home half of the fourth inning.
Third baseman, Jake Lamb.
Into the windup and the pitch. And a strike called at the letters. Looked high to me, but it's nothing and one. Now a fastball off the plate away, a ball and a strike.
Hey, that's not a bad pitch right there. That two-seamer moving away from a left-handed hitter. Didn't get the strike, but I like the idea behind the pitch.
Ready with the 1-1 pitch.
D-Rod.
Fastball, and he swings through it to fall behind.
The difference maker in this outing than others is the two-seamer. He's doing whatever he wants to do with that ball. It's moving all over the place.
Here he comes on a ball and two strikes. Now the fastball is right by him as he swings and misses for the first out of the inning.
Talk about blowing it by a guy. Geez, I mean, that fastball was way behind him when the swing came through the zone. I have to think he was looking for something off speed, and he just couldn't pull the trigger on that fastball.
Here's Yasmani Tomas. As he looks at a fastball that's in there for strike one. He was a strikeout victim in his first try. Here's the pitch. Here's a fastball that crowds him a bit, and it's 1-1. From the windup, the 1-1 pitch. A wave and a miss, a tick behind a good fastball.
If you're going to catch up to a high fastball like that, it's all about getting that front foot down in enough time to allow your hands to start moving forward. He was way too late there.
That misses, and we're even at 2-2.
Well, I like the pitch idea. It looked like he tried to get into chase right there, making him think that ball's over the plate and it runs away, but he laid off it. I don't know how, but he did.
50th pitch of the game on its way. Oh, a fastball swung on and missed, and for the second time today, he's gone on strikes.
This guy is really locked in on the bump right now. He's just playing good old-fashioned hardball right now, just rearing back and letting it go, and it seems like this lineup, they don't have an answer for anything he's bringing so far.
Brandon Drury will bat next. And Dan, it seems like this starter is just dominating the game right now. Feels like we're seeing a lot of three up, three down innings.
No doubt about that, Matt. Hey, I've enjoyed watching him go about his business, but I'm also interested to see if this offense can figure out a way to get a couple of cracks in his armor before it gets too late.
Yeah, that remains to be seen. Harvey steps into his windup. Here's the first pitch. Takes a look at one catching the outside corner. Into the windup, here comes the 0-1. 1-1. Bases are empty here with two men out. And now a curveball that's low and in the dirt for a ball. It's 2-1. The pitch. He's fallen behind now. 3-1.
Well, he falls behind 3-1 right now, but man, he is really throwing the ball well. He's been attacking them all game.
Here comes the 3-1 pitch. Swing and a little tapper, but that one rolls foul. Something has to give. Here's the payoff pitch. And this one misses inside, a ball he walked him, and they've got themselves a two-out base runner.
Well, they've been unable to get to this guy, so they'll take base runners any way they can get him. At the very least, you make him work from the stretch and add to his pitch total.
Digging in, Chris Owings. One for one as he reached base with a double his first time up. And a fastball just a bit high.
Tying run at first base, he's got to make sure that a ball in the gap, he scores. He's got to get a great jump. And one way to do it, as soon as you see that ball through the zone and you see the swing and it makes contact, you just got to get flying.
Ready with the 1-0. Runs outside, so it goes to 2-0 now.
Seems to me like they're pitching him a little bit more cautiously after that double he had his first time up.
Popped up. Back behind second. And try as he might, but he can't escape the tag there, and the inning is over. One left for the Diamondbacks. They still trail 1-0. Here now is Asdrubal Cabrera. He'll get his side started in the inning. And Dan, so far they've been stifled offensively since the first inning.
Boy, they sure have, Matt. They came out of the gates and got hot right away, but whatever was going for them pretty much has disappeared. We'll see if they can wake it back up.
And now some action in that Arizona bullpen, as it looks like they'll have both a lefty and a righty up to throw. Line shot to first, and there's one away.
The center fielder, number 12, Juan Lagares.
Ready for another shot now, Juan Lagares. One for two with a double on his line thus far. First pitch on its way. And he takes ball one.
He hasn't used that pitch much this game. That's one he's been working on in the bullpen, and now he's brought it into the game. If he's able to incorporate that in his stuff, look out.
And he won't bite at that one either. It's 2-0.
Well, that's good hitting. You know why? Because he's looking for one specific pitch. Those pitches are close. It looks like to us he's laying off them, but they're not what he wants, so he didn't swing.
Here comes the 2-0 pitch. A called strike over the outside part of the plate.
That was a good 2-0 slider right there. Now you're still sitting 2-1. I continue to look for that fastball, but that was a nice slider right there.
Two balls and a strike. Here it comes. Drilled right back up the middle and into center field as he's aboard with a one-out single.
A lot of base hits up the middle. Set your sights up the alleys and try to take it back up the middle hard like he did right here. Nice job.
Here's Jay Bruce now. Swing, and this is hit hard but foul toward the third base dugout. Line fouled off to the left and a few rows back.
Well, it's clearly on that fastball. He hit that one hard. He just could not keep it fair.
The 0-2 delivery. Good job to spoil that one away, and he stays alive. Runner at first here, one man out. And here's a fastball on 0-2, but it misses. 1-2 now. One and two, here it comes. To two balls and two strikes now. And a swing and a miss as they got him with the slider there, two away.
Oh, man, he's been absolutely getting overmatched at the plate the last couple of games. That's his fifth strikeout in this series alone. So clearly this pitching staff, they figured out how to attack this guy. We'll see if he can make any adjustments.
Now a snap throw to first and a dive, but he's back. Here's Neil Walker. He swings and hits it foul off to the right and out of play. Oh, one pitch on its way. Swing and a miss way behind the big fastball.
Just getting blown away so far. No reason to throw anything else to speed up his bat. Just stay right there.
Oh, and two, here it is. Froze him for strike three, and that retires the side. Mets strand one, but they lead it 1-0. At the plate, Patrick Corbin. He'll start things out here in the home fifth, and it's been tough sledding for this lineup through the first half of the game.
Yeah, they haven't had any momentum going to the plate so far in this one, Matt. They need something to break their way and wake them up a bit.
Be nice to get these fans involved at some point as well. Into the windup and the pitch. Way in front of that fastball. Looking at a tough pitch called a strike. Into the windup. Here comes the 0-2 pitch. Inside, as he might be trying to set him up here, 1-2. And they really bunch him up on that one as he swings and misses for the first out. That was a nasty looking slider that time.
Yeah, that was really well executed, Matt. A classic strikeout pitch. You think it's fastball middle in, then it starts bearing in on your back leg, and unless you hit it out front, there's nothing much you can do with that.
Standing in now, Jeff Mathis. As he rips it on the ground to second. And that finds its way into center for a one-out base hit. Number nine batter comes through that time as it'll now be up to the top of the order with one away.
Center fielder, A.J. Pollock.
Digging in once again, A.J. Pollock. 1-for-2 on his line so far in the game. And this is going to be fouled into the diamond level seats. Oh, and one, here it comes. Now a changeup in on the hands that evens it at 1-1. From the belt, kicks and deals. And there's ball two now. He's set, and the 2-1 pitch. Start of that swing a bit too early. Ready on two balls and two strikes. Here it comes. Here's a swing and a ground ball. Runners on first with one down. Oh, and he's going to get rung up on a curveball, and that looked like a questionable strike at best, two away.
I think we're starting to see the frustration mount from this offense. It's been a pretty dominant performance on the mound, and these hitters have had no answer for anything he's throwing up there. That will wear on you if it lasts throughout most of the game like it has here.
In now, David Peralta, as he'll look at a fastball too high for ball one. He was a ground out victim last time up. Fastball, and that thing got up there at 95 miles an hour, a ball and a strike. There's a swing and a high drive into left center field. Lagares ranging back, but he's not going to get this one. It's into the gap. Mathis is on his way home. And he's going to score with ease as the throw will be too late.
When this thing left his bat, I started thinking it might have enough to get out of here. Didn't quite carry enough, but it does one hop the wall off the track, and he cruises into second with an RBI two-bagger. You'll take that every day of the week.
Into the box, Paul Goldschmidt, as the first pitch to him is taken low and away for ball one. He's 0 for 2 in the ballgame so far. Ready with the 1-0 pitch. And, oh, looked like ball two below the knees, but it's ruled a strike, and that evens the count at 1-1.
That's a nice spot for a pitcher down there below the knees, but I think that call's a little bit low.
Harvey pauses, coming home with the 1-1 pitch. And a slider's in the dirt as he lays off it for a ball. Gets the sign. Here comes the 2-1. And a neck-high fastball that time.
3-1 count to this guy? You don't want to challenge him right here. Don't give him anything to hit. No, no, no. Keep it on the corner.
Two out here and a runner at second. Grounder hit hard down the first baseline. And a sliding attempt at first, but this sneaks by him, a base hit. The runner scores from second.
Well, that ball's hit hard right there, and it should be no surprise. That's what happens when you fall behind 3-1 in a count. You know you got to throw a fastball. You're probably going to get hit hard.
Harvey over to first, and he just manages to get his hand in. Jake Lamb standing in now. Lifted in the air out to center field. On the move is Lagares, and that retires the side. So it's two runs on three hits, no errors, and a runner left on. Five innings complete. It's the D-backs 2 and the Mets 1. Striding in once again, Michael Conforto comes into this at bat 0 for 1 in the ballgame. Conforto. Infield shifted well to the right. Here's the first pitch. And a fastball is in there for strike one. That's taken. Now it's 0-2.
You know, when a guy starts to get tired, you often see their breaking stuff start to flatten out, but that's not the case here. Still has really nice finish on that slider, as we just saw.
0-2, here it comes. Fastball swung on and missed for the first out.
Boy, he's just been setting him up and knocking him down all afternoon. We've seen a lot of punch outs from him where he didn't get much resistance. Three pitches right there and see you later.
Stepping in now, Jose Reyes. Hit the other way out toward right field. After it is Peralta. He's there, but oh, he missed it. He's around second now as they're still searching for it out there. And he will make it all the way to third now as that mistake proves a costly one indeed.
Well, the sun was definitely a factor there, but here's the news. The sun rises every day, and as a player, you've got to find a way to deal with it. A glove, flip down, sunglasses, use something so you can catch the ball. Sometimes easier said than done, though.
Standing in now, Rene Rivera, as the first pitch to him is in there for a called strike one. It was a walk in his last trip. The 0-1 pitch. Now he swings and golfs this one into left center. It's going to work out for him as a base hit. And the runner from third crosses the plate.
Man, he turned on that fastball right there. Ripped the line drive and scored the run easy.
Matt Harvey.
Now the Diamondback skipper's up out of the dugout on his way to the mound. And we're going to have a pitching change as that's going to be off for his starter this afternoon. He'll depart with our score tied and he'll still be accountable for the runner at first. And the best he can do is a no decision in this one. T.J. McFarland enters to make an appearance on the mound as he inherits a runner at first with one out in the inning.
McFarland.
Into the box now, Matt Harvey. As he'll watch a sinker here that misses, it's ball one. Runner at first here with one away in a 2-2 ball game. Now a bunt attempt here. One there. On to first, and talk about doing the job out of the bullpen. One batter, two outs, and the inning is over. So it's one run on one hit, one error, and no one left. The 5-6 and 7 slots due up in the bottom of inning number 6, and we are tied 2-2. Digging in to try it again, Yosmani Tomas. He'll step in trying to do something about this 2-2 tie.
Yosmani.
Looks like a left-hander has begun to get loose out in that Mets bullpen. Into the windup and the pitch. Slow little grounder left side. Right there is Reyes. One away.
Now batting, second baseman, Brandon Drury.
Stepping in and ready for another shot, Brandon Drury. He's 0-for-1 thus far. First pitch of the at bat on its way. Knee high slider that he takes a look at. The windup and the 0-1. Fastball that time is nowhere close and it's even at 1-1. One out, nobody on. And that swung on and fouled straight back. Looking for the strikeout. Here's the 1-2. And the slider gets him swinging. Two gone. Good job of making him chase a pitch for the strikeout there.
Yeah, Matt, that's the advantage of getting ahead in the count. You can really force hitters to expand their zone and protect. And when they're in that mode, getting them to go after a pitch they can't do much with becomes a lot easier.
Here's Chris Owings now, as he will take strike one on the fastball here. No balls and a strike. He's working on a 1-for-2 game so far. Nothing in one count. Here it comes. Couldn't wait back. A swing and a miss.
He has been aggressive in this inning. 0-2 on this hitter. The first two outs were recorded quick because he came right after the hitter. I don't think that changes right now either. He's going to continue to be aggressive to this hitter as well.
That's back-to-back breaking balls away, but now he's got himself into a little bit of a tough spot. You probably can't throw that again, so your opponent is probably up there just looking for a fastball that he can drill.
And this one's hit on the ground, but foul. He'll try again, 1-2. And he struck him out, his eighth punch out of the ballgame, and that one ends the inning. So 1-2-3 go the Diamondbacks. Six innings complete, all square at 2-2. Welcome back to Chase Field here in Phoenix. All tied at 2 apiece as we get set to start the seventh. But before we do, let's have a look at our game summary through the first six.
Leading off for the Mets.
Now the Diamondbacks get a left-hander up and working in the bullpen. Infield in the overshift here. Now the pitch. And this one's nowhere close as that bounces to the plate for ball one. Here it comes. Sinker stays outside and is behind now 2-0. In there, 2-1.
Well, what's he looking for? 2-0 fastball right down the middle, and he took it? I don't know what he's thinking about. Maybe he thought he was going to throw him a breaking ball, but I think you got to sit fastball there.
The 2-1 now to Granderson. And he turns on this one and yanks it foul and back out of play. Into the windup. Here comes the 2-2 pitch. Got him. And that's the third time we've written a K next to his name in this one.
You know what was really impressive to me about that strikeout? He fell behind 2-0 to start the at bat. That's a pretty bad place to be, but then he kind of refocused himself and came right back with three quality pitches in a row to sit him down. That's not easy to do, but now his focus has to hone in on getting ahead on the next guy.
He could really use a knock here, 0-for-3 in the game so far. Action now in the Arizona bullpen as they have a right-hander up and throwing. The 1-0 delivery. And that is through into center field for a one-out single.
Well, when you step in the box, you got a game plan. With a sinker ball pitcher, you know if he gets it up, it's going to flatten out. If it stays down, it's going to sink hard. So you want to get that ball above the thighs, and if it's up, you hit it. If it's down, you let it go. Nice execution.
Here's Juan Lagares. There goes Cabrera. Grounded, foul. That's in there, and he's deep in the hole now, 0-2. That misses, 1-2. Ready with the 1-2. Ani's able to fight this one off, foul to the right, and the count will hold at 1-2. Hoping to send him packing, pitch on its way. Grounded to the right. He lays out, but he can't make the play, and it's through into right.
Looking for that double play ball. He got the sinker, got the ball hit on the ground, but it happened to find a hole.
Ready once again, Jay Bruce. He's working on a 1-for-3 thus far. In the dirt, and now let's see. Goes to third with it, and he is in there at third as the possible go-ahead score. So now two men in scoring position. Ready with the 1-0 pitch. And they roll the dice with the squeeze, and he gets it down. So they get the out at first, but the run will score on the suicide squeeze. So a gutsy call there, as that takes some serious stones to call the suicide squeeze this late in the game, but the go-ahead run comes in to score. Here's Neil Walker, as he looks at a fastball that misses off the plate for ball one. So far, 2-for-3 in this one. And a sinker dips too low there, into the dirt, in fact.
This inning really feels like it's getting away from him out there. As a reliever, you can't let that happen. Nothing you can do about what's already happened, and it's only going to get worse if you're not focusing on the guy in the batter's box.
Looking to keep this a one-run game, the pitch. Fly ball out toward left center field. Pollock giving chase. And that's the third out. Mets forced to settle for one here in the inning. Seventh inning stretch time coming up here in the desert. It's the Mets 3 and the Diamondbacks 2. Fernando Salas gets the call from the pen to take over on the mound and start the home seventh.
Fernando Salas.
Gregor Blanco will pinch hit here, and he's the potential tying run.
Gregor Blanco.
Action in the Mets bullpen now. It's both a lefty and a right-hander that start to throw. Breaking ball for a strike, 0-1. The 0-1 on its way.
That's a ball.
And there's one well above the zone for a ball. Swing and a miss out in front of a changeup.
Well, clearly he's not sitting changeup with that swing. I like the early changeup. Now it sets up your fastball and all your other off-speed stuff, because now the changeup, anything's faster than that. He's got him off balance now.
Set to deal on a ball and two strikes.
Three.
Swung on and missed. He didn't even come close to contact on a ball way out of the zone. One out.
For me, check swings are right there next to bang-bang plays at first, as the most difficult calls for an ump to make. Taking a look at show motion, the batter doesn't appear to hold up enough, so I think the call was right.
In now, Jeff Mathis. Now a swing and a high fly ball, and this one has some carry on it to deep right field. And plenty of room out there for Granderson, and there are two away now.
Center fielder number 11.
Digging in once again,
A.J. Pollock.
He was sent packing on strikes in his last trip. Here's the first pitch to him. This is hit down the right field line, but it's going to get out of play for strike one.
Get a hit.
on. He takes something off there and had him way out in front for strike two.
One pitch away from wrapping up a very good innings work out of the bullpen here.
This should end the inning as it's sent out to second. Walker has it, and that will conclude matters here in the seventh. Diamondbacks down in order. Still a 3-2 ball game.
J.J. Hoover comes on to work now, and he's their usual closer, but this is obviously not a save opportunity.
Yeah, and this is all about just getting him some work, guys. He hasn't had a chance to come in and close a game out for several days now, so they're just hoping they can keep him sharp and give him a chance to pitch in a real game situation here.
Michael Conforto.
Michael Conforto is at the plate now, and he takes a cold strike. Into the windup, here comes the 0-1. Grounded sharply, but right at that loaded side of the infield. And he'll step on first for the out, three unassisted.
Number seven, Jose Reyes.
So digging in now, Jose Reyes. He reached base on an error and later came around to score last time up. Now the pitch. Just got a piece up the line, but it gets foul. This one, everything we could have hoped for. 3-2 in inning number eight. Lifted the other way to left center. Tomas has it in his tracks. Two gone.
Up next for the Mets.
Standing in, Rene Rivera. He singled earlier, making him 1-for-2 to this point. First pitch coming. Here it is. A fastball here as he'll take a look at ball one. 1-0. The windup and the 1-0 pitch. Fastball stays way up that time for ball two. Here's a swing and a high pop up, drifting toward the third base dugout, and no one can get there. It's a foul ball. Hit down the third baseline, but this will be a foul ball as that evens things at 2-2. 2-2 count, here it comes. Swing and he pops him up over toward foul territory. And no one can get there. He'll try it again. Into the windup, here comes the 2-2 pitch. Breaking ball as this runs in on him and he has to step out of the way that time. Seventh pitch of the at-bat coming up. And he'll try to hold up in time, but to no avail as he went around and the inning is over. Nothing across here this half. Not too many more shots left. Home half of the eighth coming up. And now here comes Mets skipper Terry Collins out to home plate, and it looks like we'll see a double switch here. Josh Edgen will come on now, and he'll slide into the seventh spot in the lineup following the double switch.
Number 6,
T.J. Rivera is into the ballgame as well, as he'll slide into the pitcher's spot, hitting ninth now on the double switch.
Number 54.
Trying to pick things up where we left off. David Peralta, he'll get things started now in the bottom of inning number eight. Now action in the bullpen as their closer starts to get loose out there. First pitch is a slider called for a strike. Now the 0-1. A good knee-high changeup taken for a strike. Here it comes on nothing and two. Fouled back. Here's another 0-2. Again, he sends it out of play. Now another 0-2. And a good bite to that slider as he swings through it for the first out of the inning.
People always talk about how important getting the leadoff men on base is, and it's true. So in the eighth inning of a one-run game, that's a really nice job of attacking a hitter and sending him packing.
Here's Paul Goldschmidt now. He's got a hit in three at-bats to this point. First pitch on its way. Off the plate and away there. One ball, no strikes. A ball and no strikes. Here it is. Right over the middle, knee high. He's set. Here comes the 1-1. Two and one. Hitters count now. Here's the 2-1. Now a ball hit high in the air and deep down the line in left. And a big sigh of relief on the mound as that nearly tied it, but this ball is foul.
His timing looks good right there, Matt. That's falling up after a fastball. He still is able to get a piece of that breaking ball.
And this pitch is taken high and away to fill the count. It's 3-2. And he lays off ball four. So now the potential tying run here is aboard late in the game.
Well, the reason power hitters generally draw more walks than other guys is exactly what we saw right there. Pitchers work around them and nibble the corners a lot more so they don't get burned. He made some good pitches, but he just couldn't get him to chase enough out of the zone.
Jake Lamb standing in now. No hits in three tries so far. He's struck out once. Quick check on that tying run at first. And he'll dive back in safely. Here comes the first pitch. Started to go around, but it's ruled strike one anyway. Here's the 0-1. Takes a pitch high and away for ball one.
And the reason he's working away so much here is because he's got that big hole on the right side of the infield to worry about. With the first baseman holding the runner on, it's always smart to pitch into the defense you have behind you.
Come on, let's keep it going.
Here's the 1-1 pitch. Pitch is a cold strike. The throw. Not in time as he steals second.
Hey, 90 feet is a big deal when you're talking about a one-run game, so that's a little risky. But, hey, sometimes you have to be aggressive and force the other team to stop you.
Looking for the strikeout. Here's the 1-2. And now a pitch hit sharply on the ground.
Oh, he might have got away with one. Two-strike breaking ball that ended up being in the zone. I think he probably wanted that out of the zone, but fortunately, he just fouled it off.
And another foul ball. Here he comes again, 1-2. And that slider's almost in the dirt.
This guy's a good hitter. He's seen a lot of pitches already, fouling balls off. But as the pitcher, I got to keep throwing him strikes. And if he hits it, hopefully it's at somebody.
A 2-2 count. Here's the pitch. Swing and a miss, and they'll dodge a major bullet that time. Two away.
Yeah, as they say, there's a hole in his swing in that location, so a good job there of exploiting that. That can be real hard for some guys to overcome when teams start figuring out what locations you just can't handle.
Hansel Robles enters here looking to get the final out before the ninth inning. Here's Yasmani Tomas. It's been a rough go of things at the plate for him so far, but his guys are looking for him to change that right here.
Yeah, nothing better than coming through for the boys in a tight game, Matt, especially when you're kind of due to do something productive.
Come on now.
trying to hold the lead. Here's the delivery. First pitch hack in here, and that's the first strike. The 0-1 on its way. Squared that one up just a little late. The 0-2 home. Struck him out. Struck him out again, I should say. His third punch out of the game. Mets bullpen able to stem the tide. We've played eight full. The Mets are out on top, 3-2. Fernando Rodney is called upon, and it's not for his usual role. Just hoping to keep the deficit at one here. Stepping into the box, T.J. Rivera. He'll be charged with trying to get on board, leading off the ninth. Off we go in the ninth as the first pitch misses for ball one.
That's a big fastball, obviously, and we're going to see this reliever throw it a lot.
The windup and the 1-0 pitch. And he won't bite at that one either. It's 2-0. All over the place to start the ninth. It's 3-0 now.
Well, knowing the threat this guy poses if he gets on base, I think the next pitch should be a challenge pitch. You don't want to give guys that can run a free chance to cause havoc out there, especially the leadoff guy.
That one's in there, 3-1. Into his motion, here comes the 3-1. Takes a high fastball for a strike. He's ready. Now the payoff pitch. Hit on the ground out to short. Throw on to first for the out, and that is how the ninth inning gets underway.
The right fielder, number 3, Curtis Granderson.
In is Curtis Granderson. He's hitless in 3 at-bats to this point. And here's a fastball called for strike one. Into the windup, here comes the 0-1.
Nope.
And the changeup is way low that time. Bases are empty, one man out. Now a ball sliced out of play down the left field line. And he lays off a pitch outside as they draw even at 2-2. Into the windup, here comes the 2-2 pitch. And he struck him out again. So that's the old sombrero there, partner. 4 strikeouts in the ballgame.
Wow, he's just a lost cause in this one. That's the 4th time he struck out in this game alone, and that's not something you'll forget very quickly. That's about as bad of a day as you can have.
Here now is Asdrubal Cabrera. The fastball here as he'll take a look at ball one, 1-0. He comes into this appearance in the midst of a 1-for-4 day. One-oh count, here it is. Takes a look at one catching the outside corner. 2 out, nobody on. And a good spot for that pitch is it's chopped foul.
Tell you what, that was a nice swing after the sequence, following a fastball to get a changeup when you foul it off. Pretty good approach.
Struck him out, so it remains a 1-run lead as they head in for their final set of swing. Nothing across here this half of the inning. Nothing further in the ninth for the Mets. Last chance coming up now for Arizona. Jerry's Familia takes the ball now in inning number 9, looking to close the door.
Jerry's Familia.
Brandon Drury will bat next.
Leading up,
0 for 2 with a walk for him so far.
Second baseman, number 27.
Good slider there, and he gets ahead of him, nothing and one. Swing and a miss, and he's in trouble now, 0-2. The 0-2 delivery. Half swing here, but it won't matter. It's strike three called anyway, and that's out number one.
When your closer comes in and strikes out the first guy he faces, everyone on the team can kind of take a deep breath. Still have two more outs to get, but retiring that leadoff guy is always huge when you're trying to shut a game down.
First pitch of the at bat. Chris Owings is in with one away now as he swings and misses here at strike one.
Two things pitchers really love: called strike threes and jamming hitters. How about that? Talk about that jam right there. That's about as good as it gets.
That misses. 1-1 the count now to the Arizona shortstop. One out, nobody on. And a slider's in the dirt as he lays off it for a ball. He's set, and the 2-1 pitch. And this one's going to bounce up to the plate. An easy take there, and it's 3-1 now.
Well, this has been a good job to work the count from 0-1 to 3-1, and now he's really in the driver's seat to see a heater that he can do something with.
Set. Here's the 3-1. And he'll just get a piece here as this is chopped foul at home plate. Pitch on the way. Still hanging with him. Another good swing to keep it going. He'll try it again, 3-2. And he strikes him out as well. So make it back-to-back punch outs here to the first two men he faces out of the bullpen.
Well, you have to feel pretty confident about the way this one's going to end up as a manager. Two hitters, two strikeouts from the closer. There's not a whole lot more he can do to instill confidence that he's going to wrap this thing up without any problem.
Daniel Descalzo will grab a bat and hit for the pitcher here.
Descalzo!
And that one stayed too low, apparently. First two men in the inning have both gone down via the punch out, so we'll see if he can fare any better. The 1-0 pitch. And he watches one miss outside, 2-0 now.
It's never advantageous to fall behind 2-0 as a pitcher, but if you're going to do it, it's far better to do it with a guy down in the bottom of the order. Time for a challenge fastball right here, though.
Here comes the 2-0 pitch. Just got a piece of it as it's fouled back. Hitters count now. Here's the 2-1. Sent foul again, and after being way ahead, now it's even at 2-2. Has them down to their final strike. Here it comes. 3-2 now. He's set. Here's the 3-2. And he lays off ball four. So now the potential tying run here is aboard late in the game.
Man, that's just painful for a pitcher right there. A 3-2 offering that was right on the corner, but he couldn't get him to chase, and he doesn't get the call. Can't beat yourself up about that one too much.
Chris Herrmann will be called upon here to hit with the game on the line.
Chris Herrmann.
Time called here, as with the potential tying run aboard, they'll make the move to get a little more speed out there. Here's a sinker to start him out, but he wouldn't bite. It's ball one. He'll be looking for something he could drive into the gap and drive home that tying run from first. One and oh pitch on the way. There's a knee-high pitch that catches the zone. Two out with the man at first. And this is swung on and missed, so the Diamondbacks are down to their final strike now.
Wow, not sure what that was, but talking about having your mind made up you're going to swing before the pitcher even throws a pitch, I don't know how you swing at that pitch.
Ready to deliver the 1-2. Checked his swing there, and did he go? No, he did not, says the third base umpire. Ball two. As a look, now the pitch. And a slider runs in on him as he has to lean out of the way.
All right, 3-2 count with two outs. The runner on first will be moving, so we'll see what happens. There are a lot of possible outcomes with this kind of play.
Come on! Pitch your pitch, man!
Ready to deliver the full count pitch. Just staying alive, putting together a really good at-bat here. Ready now with the payoff pitch. And he struck him out for out number three. So that'll wrap things up here as they leave the possible tying run stranded at first.
Yeah, it's only been a week, but I guess it probably feels like a million years ago since they had their last win. But this six-game losing streak is behind them now. So we'll see if they can string some W's together.
A one-run game this afternoon, 3-2, the final finish. Matt Harvey wins his third of the season. Jerry's Familia wraps it up for the save, his fourth of the season. So that's a wrap for this afternoon. For Harold, Dan, and the rest of our crew, I'm Matt Vasgersian. You've been watching MLB Network.